Greetings, everybody. Welcome. Thanks for tuning in. Sorry for my delay in the last episodes I tried to make. However, I had some software issues, but I'm back here. I'm your host, Krusty Canuck, and this is episode 11. Basically, I'm just going to reiterate what I said in my last podcast in regards to the hate mail I've received and, of course, the whole liberal debacle on white supremacy. And I'm also going to reflect on how Justin Trudeau still wants to do photo ops at the expense of others. So, back to my hate mail. As I said in my podcast before, okay, I've had a few people make comments. I encourage it. By all means, get a hold of me. Talk to me. If you want to debate about something, by all means. I'm open for debate. I'm open for suggestions. I've actually had a few kind suggestions on my comments page in regards to lighting. So I fixed it. And I've also had a few comments when it comes to pronunciation. Needless to say, okay, take into consideration. But when little kids, and I will say little kids because they act like children, making false accusations saying that I'm fascist when I've already described the term of fascism to you, based on an actual encyclopedia, not just hearsay, or what the general consensus is when it comes to trendy buzzwords, yeah. If you praise the state, if you want the state to look after your needs, you either lean towards the manifest or the fascist manifest. Now, any dictator in his or her mind would sit there and dictate how people have to be 24/7 and what they have to give to the government accordingly is a borderline fascist or borderline communist way. Now, we live in a democracy, which I love. Right? I believe in voting. I believe in paying reasonable taxes, meaning taxes which are actually going to prolong something rather than drag out something like our national debt, Mr. Morneau. I don't believe in carbon tax. I don't believe that the earth is going to die in 12 years. And I sure as hell don't think that our elected officials have any business running things or calling the shots. So, when it comes to the whole carbon tax, Miss Freeland, yeah, and Miss Climate Barbie, Miss McKenna, and of course our favorite Canadian daughter, Miss Ikra Khalid, weighing in on the whole carbon tax issue. Oh, climate change is real, and we have to give more money and take more money from the Canadian citizen. Bullshit. If anyone wants to challenge me on that, by all means, leave me a comment. Links will be below this broadcast. Right? Just because I fill up my car and truck with gasoline and I heat my home with gas and sometimes electric energy, does it mean I have to be punished? Fine, okay. Then I'll make a big bonfire and I'll go buy some wood to keep things warm, keep things going. Because I tell you, right here and now, it's been snowing all day. Not bad for May 1st. And it's a little cool outside, so I turn the heat up. Now, I deserve to pay an extra $20, $30, $40 a month because of that. I might go into town and get some groceries. Oh, shit. I might have to put some more gas in my truck. Oh, it's going to cost me an extra $20 a tank, right? Because I'm just a dirty polluter, right? Yes. Come on, people. Wake up. So anybody wants to challenge me on this environmental debacle and being called a fascist, by all means, bring it to my attention. Let's have a debate. Let's discuss this as adults, shall we? Right? But if you're going to sit there and keep throwing words around like fascist or racist, oh my God, you're a misogynist. You're not embracing any kind of challenge. Right? You're just being told what to say, when to say it, because somebody disagrees with you. I disagree with paying ridiculous amounts of tax to fill in the void that the federal government leaves. I disagree with having to pay taxes every April and May because some people at the CRA can't do the fucking math, right? I disagree with having to pay taxes for someone who's able-bodied to get up and do something with their lives. That's just me. That's the libertarian side of me. Why should I foot the bill for someone else when they're capable of doing something on their own, right? I don't mind helping seniors out. I don't mind volunteering my time, helping those less fortunate. I don't mind helping the Legion. I don't mind helping a neighbor or a friend or a buddy that needs it. Hell, even if someone's on the road and having trouble changing the tire. Yeah, I'll give them a hand. Probably because that's the way I was raised.
What?
How were you raised, kids? When you sit there, point the finger and call me fascist. You're a fascist. You're a misinformed little shit. And I'll say that. I will say that. Right? I've had some help from some other authorities. I've had some help from my parents when I needed it. Right? I've also paid them back. This room I'm in is part of my home. A home that my wife and I invested in. Where we saved money, put a down payment on, and paid the mortgage loyally. Right? For you kids out there that point fingers and condemn people for calling them rich, or you're supporting rich fascists, really? How am I supporting rich fascists? I'm not rich. If I was rich, I'd have my own TV studio. Or I'd have my own radio station where I'd play all the music that I like and have the masses listen to. Better yet, I'm sitting in my house at my expenses, paying my bills with my money that I've earned, working two part-time jobs and on a pension. So don't hand me your crap and your false dichotomies when it comes to who's fascist in this country. Get out and read a book. Understand what the Communist Manifesto did in the 20th century. Understand what Adolf Hitler and Benito Mussolini and, of course, the Emperor of Japan back in the 30s promoted with their fascist ideologues. Then you can just sit there and decide who's fascist or not. Right? You want to praise the state? You want to praise leadership? Hey, by all means. But the moment that leadership does something stupid, i.e. put us into debt, and then sit there and lie about it, and then start pointing fingers calling people racist when they question certain motives, i.e. the immigration policy in this country, where our money is going in this country, and how lack our government does not invest in this country, then who's the fascist then? Puts things in perspective now, doesn't it? Yeah. But what the hell do I know? I'm just a crusty old vet.
Oh, you're a fascist.
Blow it out your ass, kids. You want to debate with me? You know where to find me. Period. That simple. Let's set up a conference. Let's set up a video conference. Right? Hell, a phone call or something. I'm going to record it because I'll eventually put it on this channel and on my podcast. However, you want to debate? Let me know. We'll work something out. Right? Shit simple. Well, enough of that. Now the whole white supremacy issue that Miss Freeland graciously discussed in the last G7 last month. I'll leave a link at the end of the page. Sitting there saying that white supremacy is such an issue in this country. How do you figure, Miss Freeland? How do you honestly figure that white supremacy is such a rampant virus in this country? When you have working class Canadians of all colors and creeds, all religions, getting together doing the Elevest rally to tell Ottawa, shit or get off the pot when it comes to the pipeline. How is that racist? How is it racist to tell the government, you gotta take responsibility for your shit, just like I do, what my wife does, what my employers do, what my other employers have done, what my subordinates have done, all the time. And yet when we question your judgment when it comes to illegal immigration, which it is, just walking across the border expecting magical things to happen, right? Because you and I both know, you the viewer and my listeners, any country you go to, you got to have a passport. You don't have a passport, guess what? You get detained. And it doesn't matter how friendly said country is or how unfriendly it is. You got to have a passport. Okay. If there are genuine people out there that are really hurting and fleeing persecution, by all means, come to Canada. Okay? Because in this country, you have the opportunity to help yourself, to get ahead, and create opportunities for your and people around you. I know that because I worked for immigrants back in my teenage years. They came to Canada with barely anything in their pockets. And my employer at that time, he barely spoke a word of English. But he overcame, and he adapted. He created a great business, created a few chains, or correction, a few restaurants, sorry, and he employed me very well for a couple of years. I had constant work while I was going to school, and I was learning a thing or two about Chinese cuisine. Pretty good trade-off. But he was also a decent human being, too. He was compassionate. He was caring. because he chose to be. He chose to come to Canada to create a better life for him and his family and his loved ones, and he did it. And last I heard, he owns 6 restaurants in the Greater Toronto Area. Good for him, right? Well done, sir, you know? So what's that tell you? Does that make me a fascist? Does that make me a racist? No, it makes me a fucking realist, right? It can be done here, right? Right now, I'm understanding the trade of gunsmithing, the finer points of machining and craftsmanship. I'm also understanding the finer points of carpentry and small engine mechanics. Why? People need small engine mechanics. People like carpenters, and I like working with my hands. And I like the smell of wood when I chop it and put it together. It's fantastic. That's my thing. I can make that happen. Why? Because I intend to persevere. I intend to overcome. And I intend to get the fucking job done. Right? That's the opportunity I have. That's the opportunity that anybody in this country has. Right? But I've never broken the law. I've never lied to anybody in the Queen's Bench or any authority thereof. And I've gotten ahead. I've overcome a lot of obstacles. And I'm here today to say so. But I'll save that for another episode. But in the meantime, when it comes to white supremacy that the Liberal government has been peddling every time a yellow vest speaks up or any time someone else speaks up against the so-called status quo that has been reigning us since 2015, it's not white supremacy, Miss Freeland, or whatever government official. It's people speaking their goddamn mind in this democracy. We do have free speech under our Charter of Rights and Freedoms, in case you have forgotten that. In case you have forgotten that people in this country have the right to associate and speak their bloody minds. I may disagree with somebody saying this. I may disagree with someone saying that. But guess what? That's life. As I mentioned in my podcast, you don't want to hear something on television or see something on television? Change the channel. The radio? Change the station. Don't like what you read in the paper? Well, you can either write a rebuttal. Choice is yours. People in this country are protesting, and it doesn't matter if they're white, black, pink, purple, Catholic, Jewish, Muslim, or spaghetti enthusiasts. They have every right to speak their mind. Period. Okay? Church and state does not mix. Do you understand that concept? It doesn't matter if it's Christian, doesn't matter if it's Jewish, or Muslim, or spaghetti, or atheism, or sun worship. It doesn't matter. Common sense politics is what prevails. And yet you liberals constantly forget that with your virtue bullshit. Right? I'm not a racist. I am a Canadian and I'm a patriot. That flag that's behind me right now, that's a part of my history. That's a part of history that I enjoy, regardless of what your perspective is on it. When you look at the three lions, the one lion, the harp, the fleur-de-lis, and the three maple leaves, that represented Canada as a whole at the time. Now, yes, we are diverse, and there are many other too. Many other people and from different walks of life who has prospered and grown and done great things. Well done to those sirs and madams who have done that. But there are also people of all walks and creeds that take advantage of the system, and it doesn't matter what color they are, right? That's just a question of their character, and that's what I judge on. And I hate to tell you, Miss Freeland, and the other liberal cronies that shake your finger at white supremacy and your other ghost hunting bullshit, a lot of Canadians judge on character. Period. And if anyone out there wants to challenge me on that, by all means, let me know in the comments below. Let me know via Podbean. Let me know via email. Let me know. Tell me what you think. Anyhow, that's enough of my little rant today, my little spiel. It's just nice to come back and get a video done for you all. And if you'd like, please subscribe to the video and to my Podbean account. I'll leave links below. And please consider donating to either my PayPal, Subscribestar. Well, every little bit helps. As I've mentioned before, 30% of every sale from my t-shirt line and through my donations, I will graciously give to the Calgary Veterans Food Bank because veterans need to eat, right? So I've been Krusty Canuck. Hope you all do okay. Look after your loved ones. And remember, humanity and merit wins the day. Bye for now.